Higher chakras, interesting topic. Are you aware of the higher chakras? What does it mean?
From the solar plexus up.
Okay.
Up to the three.
Okay.
Up to the crown and
three, four.
Okay. Okay, so let us go step by step about what actually the higher chakras are. And by higher chakras, we are going to more talk about the higher dimensional chakras, which are higher than even the crown chakra. So once we had a talk, I think around 2 years ago, where we spoke about the seven chakras. So in addition to seven chakras, there are more chakras which are called as the higher chakras, which we are going to discuss today. Now there is not much literature available right now on this, but whatever is there, you know, and I'm sharing it today. And the basic reason behind sharing this particular topic is for us to get aware that apart from the physical body, apart from what we see, there is much more to us. So we'll be talking a lot about other things like higher dimensions and a lot more. So let us begin with it. My name is Ashwini Chube, as you know me. I'm a motivational speaker, spiritual teacher, coach. I run a company named Unicorn Insight. I also do transformational trainings and a lot of healing modalities, right from Reiki to Access Consciousness and a lot more. So let us begin with the higher chakras, okay? So to make things interesting, I'm going to talk about the Atlantis. Have you heard of the term Atlantis?
Atlantis, I heard, but not the Atlantis.
Okay. But you heard that of Atlantis? Apart from what is the hotel in the Middle East, there is a hotel in Middle East, we are not talking about that. Because everyone talks about Atlantis as that.
In mythology,
So correct. Many eons ago, centuries ago, Atlantis was supposedly a high vibrational place, which was located somewhere where currently there is the Atlantic Ocean. Okay, now this particular place had extremely high vibrations, and it was a place where people had magical superpowers. Right now, today, the world we are living in, when we talk about those superpowers, we call it a myth or we call it mythology. What is mythology? No one knows whether that exists.
True or not.
True or not. Someone has heard about it. It has come across to us as a story. The reason we call something myth is because right now, the human brain, which we think about, doesn't know how to comprehend that. Having said that, it doesn't mean it never existed. Because there are some things which our human mind right now at this stage in 2019 cannot register. But at that point of time, the vibrations of Earth were extremely high, because of which Atlantis was a high dimensional, high vibrational place. Okay, so they say that people had superpowers. People used to interact with each other through telepathy. The clairs, what we call as the superpowers, were highly activated. People could see the future. People could know what is going on in someone's mind. People could sense what to do. So, you know, clairsentience, which is clear sensing. Claircognizance, which is receiving message from the divine. Clairvoyance, which is seeing things beyond the eye. And clairaudience, which is the super hearing. The clairs were super active and it was a very natural way. Healing was just by sending energy and things used to work out. The high priests and the high priestesses of Atlantis had superpowers which they could pass on to their students, and everyone was given an activity. The souls were very high vibrating. The concept of fear was not there. The only thing which has made the current world live the way it is the concept of fear. And when the fear element got in, so then what started happening was, people had superpowers, and then the powers seemed to be improperly used. And that was the reason, slowly and gradually, the continent started sinking. But there were several Atlantis experiments. They said it was not just one, there were several experiments. Towards the end, when the last experiment failed, it was again withdrawn, and they say that the land split up into many areas. Some part of it, a large part of it, sunk, and some parts of it are still existing. Some say some islands in the Atlantic Ocean, some say Greece, some say even islands like Bali. There's a lot of the remains of Atlantis are still there, and that's why there are some mystical lands even today in today's world where we do not know, but they have different high vibrations. So the reason we call this Atlantis experiment is because it was an experiment at that particular time whether Earth is able to live up to the high vibrational, higher dimensional experience. Unfortunately, it failed, and currently we are living in the world, the current world, which is the current reality. Having said that, what dimensions really are? Now, how many of us love Hollywood over here? I love Hollywood. I watch a lot of these movies. I have
Doctor
been watching.
Strange.
Yeah. So I think this was one of the amazing movies which released a few years ago. So did Interstellar. And so they say that spirituality and science walk hand in hand, and there is a place where they meet. So this movie was talking more about the scientific science fiction. That's what the genre of this movie is. And both movies are my favorites, and I watched it.
Out of body experience.
Yes, and the way the dialogues between the wise one, that is the teacher, and Dr. Strange himself are just beyond amazing. So I think these movies, the only reason I'm giving this is for all you viewers to understand that what dimensions really are. And people ask me, okay, when you talk about dimensions, what do you really mean? Are they places? So people believe, okay, this is the third dimension, maybe some other places, fourth dimension, fifth dimension. So what is your thought process about dimension? What do you think dimensions are?
See, fourth dimensions are known.
Mm-hmm.
That is, and the fifth one is supposed to be the spiritual one.
Right.
With length, breadth, height, and time.
Right. Right.
So these are the four. And thought is supposed to be moving in this four dimension. And now they have added the fifth one, that
yes.
The spiritual one. It goes, means it is going to what you call, there is no concept of time for
absolutely.
It. It is so going
So I think you are very much in track with, in track with what we are going to talk about today. So time and space is only third dimensional quality. That's what they say. There is a lot more to study on this topic, but today we are going to cover whatever we can in easy language, everything what you all can understand, what I have understood, and what our viewers who are watching us on video would like to learn about. So let us just quickly go to what dimensions are. So dimensions are nothing, but they are states of mind and thinking. As simple as that. The law of attraction says, thoughts become things. Because the law of attraction is actually the law of vibration. What do we attract? We attract the way we vibrate. The experience, the frequency at which we are vibrating. We actually are attracting that in our life. And all of us know that at some point of time, the current life which we are living was a dream for us maybe a few years ago. The way we look, the way we speak, everything is a frequency. And that's why sometimes we feel after meeting some people, wow, what good energy this person has. And oh God, that meeting that person makes me feel so drained. Because the vibrations differ. The one who is high vibrational, just by being in their aura and in their physical space, you feel uplifted because they are vibrating higher. Their body, the physical body, emotional body, all bodies are vibrating really high. So dimensions are nothing but states of mind and thinking. They say that manifestation is quicker the higher you move in dimensions. So in third dimension is bound by fear. The only energy in third dimension, which the current world is living, is fear energy. So when someone, for example, someone is talking to his or her friends, oh, I have this dream of making this business, setting up this plant in this place, and I'm going to do this and do this. Most friends will tell him, you're gone mad. Right now you don't have the money. Go back to your 9-to-5 job. Don't dream big. The person, if he really wants to make that happen, he will ek kaan se sunega, dusre kaan se Totally. Yeah? He will still chase his dream. One day he will reach it. Now, what is the difference between these two persons? Some people call it optimist and pessimist. But it is much more than just optimism and pessimism. What is really happening is the one who is saying it's not possible or not practical is bound by the third dimensional reality of fear. So sure, there are failures. I'm not saying everything is easy. But the person who still believes that dream and makes it happen has something within him, something which the others don't have. And that is that sense of shunning away the fear and working. Fear energy is typically very, very third dimensional. And if someone blames you or says something to you tomorrow that things are not possible, don't blame them, because they are still vibrating at a third dimension. And it's their journey. One day they will reach where they need to reach. It's not our job to look at who is where, because we all are on this journey. We were there some time ago, someone else will be there sometime later, and there is a lot more to go for each one of us. We don't say that we are advanced and someone is not advanced. It's just that we are living in different dimensions. Manifestation is very quick as you move higher, and manifestation is at a lower level. The manifestation will take a lot of time, because you will still be working with the concept of time and space. Whereas, where you are in the fifth dimension, people say, miracle, there was a miracle. I went there, I was not supposed to get it, and I got it. Where did it come from? The person's vibrations are so high, that like a magnet, they attracted that thing. Because the basis of fifth dimensional principle is, when you desire something, and if you think as if you already have it, it will become yours in no time. So the fourth dimension says that I will attract it by my power and get it to me. The fifth dimension says I already have it. I just have to reach there in time. So here is the difference between fourth and fifth dimension. We are going to learn much in detail in the next slide. So this is a quick teaser, as I would say, because this study is quite complex, quite complicated. And there is a lot more to dimensions than this, which currently I am studying. So you maybe one fine day will talk exclusively about dimensions. But for today, before we go to the higher chakras, I want to talk what dimensions are. So the third dimension basically functions from personal desire. The fourth dimension is all about group consciousness, where you say that we are the positive thinkers and we are a group of people who believe that we know everything. That is fourth dimension. The fifth dimension is in fact universal consciousness. There we are not judging that who is good, who is bad. We are just letting everyone live their journey. In third dimension, things are to be feared. In the fourth one, we are trying to change our thoughts and perceptions to release fear. Whereas in fifth dimension, we know that there is no fear. Fear is an illusion. Way of life, third dimension will be very materialistic. You think you have to be busy all the time. Fourth dimension, you will do things to make changes. For example, you will try to use the law of attraction, you will try to use the energy, you will try to use something. You are doing things to make the desires come to you. Fifth dimension, everything is happening from inner guidance. You are just sitting, you are relaxing, and the things are coming to you. That is fifth dimension. Beliefs. Third dimension, beliefs are a lot of polarities. Have you heard of the term polarity? So polarity is good and bad. Even man and woman is a polarity.
Two extremes,
because we think we are this or we are that. In access consciousness, they say that the biggest addiction of today's world is their addiction to polarity. The moment we understand that there is no polarity, and the moment we transcend polarity, we will move at a much higher pace, and we understand that everything is possible. In fourth dimension, you see both things from a different point of view. You see the differences, and they start disappearing. In fifth dimension, there are no differences. You don't judge whether the energy is positive or negative. Right? Judgment is justified. They say that of course we will judge. We are human beings, we will judge. That is third dimension. Fourth dimension, judgment is acknowledged and accepted that okay, it's not good to judge someone. But in the fifth dimension, judgment doesn't exist. There is no judgment. Everyone is living their own life. Time is fixed in the third dimension. In the fourth dimension, time can be manipulated, which means you are trying to bend the time or do something with the time. Fifth dimension, everything is right now. Your future is now, your past is now, your present is now. You are now, this is you. Finally, reaction to negativity, which is one of the most important things which I feel all of us should know right now. In third dimension, people will say, आजकल के दिन बहुत बुरे हैं, बहुत बुरा चल रहा है. News देखता हूँ, ऐसे लगता है कि क्या चल रहा है. What are we doing? We are looking at the reality, feeling fearful, getting stressed, feeling helpless and completely, you know, stuck in that zone. In the fourth dimension, we will say, I'm avoiding the negative, I'm only focusing on the positive, which means I will avoid negative people.
But he has accepted this.
Yeah. So that person is negative, I'm going to avoid them. People are sending me negative energy, I will avoid them. These things make me feel negative, I'm avoiding them, which means you're still judging and you're choosing things which you feel are positive. What is fifth dimension? Transmutation. Negative energy, deni hai, bring it on. I will transmute it, make it to positive and I will use it. So people who are, in Sanskrit also they say that, people who are unaffected by the positive and the negative are really the one. What in Bhagavad Gita they mentioned it as Siddha Pradnya, which means the person who is fixed in his, he won't be affected by anything else. So the concept of that is living in the fifth dimension, where you are unaffected by all the energy which is coming to you. Only if someone even sends negative energy, you are unaffected because you know how to transmute it. And when we, the first session which I had here about the violet flame, where we spoke about transmutation. Transmutation is that. A true alchemist is a person who can use any negative energy thrown at him, transmute it into positive and create gold out of it. Even if you throw stones at him, he will make it to gold. And even if you throw gold chips at him, he will make it even better. So fifth dimension is actually living in the spiritual alchemy and creating out of whatever you have, knowing what you want and just being there. So of course we can always maybe learn this as a separate topic some other time. The reason why I'm talking about dimensions today is for you to understand what do you mean by the fifth dimensional higher chakras, which we are going to talk about today. So what happened after Atlantis? So the Atlantis experiment failed and it was withdrawn. So after the Atlantis was withdrawn, in Atlantis, as I said, people had superpowers. They could sense energy, they could do alchemy, they could do magic, they could have, you know, they could read someone else's mind. But people realize that these things cannot exist with the fear element. Because once fear creeps in, and if you know someone else what is there in store for the future, you could might as well use it against them. And that was the reason these superpowers were withdrawn. And what happened was the Earth's vibration shifted to third dimension from the fifth and sixth or higher dimensions. And in order to ascend to higher dimensions, all 12 chakras need to be activated. Now what happened was, so this experiment was millions and zillions years ago. Eventually, after 2012, when Earth's vibration started raising, so they say that the first wave of spiritual ascension came somewhere in the 1980s, if I'm correct, I think it is 1987. It was the first time where a whole spiritual wave came into picture. And that was a time where many children were born who were very gifted with a lot of qualities. That was the first wave of ascension which came up. 25 years later, that is in 2012, Earth's vibrations again rose up where another wave of ascension came up energetically. The universe started expanding higher. And at that particular point of time, these 12 chakras activation was the first step which started spreading towards humanity. So in order to ascend, now what is ascension? Ascension is raising your vibrations. Every day when you are doing some kind of spiritual practice or anything, I'm not just speaking about spiritual practice, but spiritual practices will help you ascend in a better manner. Always better if done with a teacher who is an ascension teacher. With a lot of knowledge people started spreading. They say that internet is also a very big step because of internet, a lot of knowledge became circulated all over the world. And the movement which started in 1987 started getting even better after 2012, where a lot of spiritual teachers started realizing or understanding their real purpose, and they started coming back into their power. they understood that, okay, I have this power and I have to seek it, and then they were automatically directed to the right teachers, to the right sources, maybe the right books came into picture. And if you really want to read, there is a lot of literature available on ascension and dimensions. I personally love the work of Dinah Cooper. Dinah Cooper is an English angel teacher and ascension teacher, and her work is amazing. So a lot of this is being inspired by her, and which I'm just trying to share here. So now, the 12 chakras needed to be activated, and currently what we have 7 chakras.
Seven.
So let me just come back and revise the 7 chakras. We have root, sacral, solar plexus, heart, throat, third eye and crown. Okay, so these are the 7 chakras which currently exist. The day I learned my Reiki level 1, this was the first lessons I learned from my teacher. How do you define energy, auras and chakra, and these 7 chakras. But now what are the higher dimensional chakras? And so with the current life we are living, the current reality we are living, most people have 7 chakras, but the 5 are evolving. If you are trying to work on yourself, you are trying to somewhere get a way to open the other 5 chakras. Because they say that most of us who are aware of this knowledge, you know, whether you are sitting here or whether you are reading something about it or whether you are watching this video, somewhere your unconscious, your subconscious mind has made you look at this information, because somewhere you believe this exists. We only see what we believe, because our mind is a very, very strong thing. We will always see what we believe in. And if we want to find information about something, we'll automatically be directed to talks, to books, to videos, to teachers who will teach us that. So probably if you are watching this today, it typically means somewhere your mind knows about it, and your mind has asked for this information. So what are the 5th dimensional chakras? The 5 chakras are as follows. The earth star chakra, I'm going to explain each one in detail. So this is just the names of those chakras. The navel chakra, causal, the soul star chakra and the stellar gateway. So these are the 5 chakras which are often called as the higher chakras. Let us learn one by one each. The first one, earth star chakra. Now we begin with, when we begin talking about the 7 chakras, we talk about
your soul.
Yeah, we start with the root, which is the base of our spine. But the earth star chakra is below our feet. Okay, now anything which is below our feet tracks us to our past. Okay, so they say that earth star chakra has a lot of linkage with our past lives, with all the lives we have learned, also with our ancestors who were us before we were there. And it is located below our feet, approximately 6 inches below our feet. This chakra is located. Now, when I mention this topic, I am also talking about the archangels with this chakra, simply because on this path to ascension, the archangels, what are angels? Again, angels are divine energy beings. Whether you see them with feathers or whether you do not see them, angels is an energy. It's a higher light energy which comes from a different realm, which is called as the realm or dimension of angels. And when we connect to them, we actually draw energy from that dimension. Angels are easy to connect. Only thing is, they operate on the law of free will, which means unless I tell an angel to help me, they cannot interfere. Unless it is a life-threatening situation and it's not time for a person to pass over, only then they will support. Otherwise, angels will only tell you when you ask for them. And if you do not ask for them, guess what? They will not do anything for you. But if you ask for them, you will be surprised how they help you. So Archangel Sandalphon is one of the angels, one of the 15 archangels, and this particular archangel works with this chakra. Now, a very strange thing about this chakra is, they say this chakra is black, some say it is black and grey and black and white, but when this chakra is activated, it picks up the color of magenta. Magenta is like a dark pink color, you know, this Rani color, what we say, very something similar to that. So, when this chakra gets activated, it is magenta, otherwise it is black. And this chakra deals with nature awareness, because of course it's below our feet. And they say Earth, which is also referred to as Mother Gaia, it connects us to that. It's the chakra of earthly existence and of rebirth and renewal. And that's the reason I said it deals with your past life and your ancestors. Because when you take rebirth, if we believe in reincarnation and we take rebirth, this is the chakra which stores those memories. So anytime people ask me that, you know what, I think I have a lot of past life issues, what do I do? I was like, okay, first, who told you about past life issues? So no, I went to a card reader or a psychic and they told me that you have past life issues. Ab main kya karu? The easy thing is, ask Archangel Sandalphon to clean your Earth Star Chakra. Do it. For any healing energetic practice to work, at least keep 21 days so that it can be worked up. So, Archangel Sandalphon deals with this chakra, which is also the chakra of renewal and rebirth. The next one is the navel chakra. Now, this chakra at most of the times is confused as solar plexus. So, now I'll tell you one very important thing. On the internet, sometimes some things are made very complicated. So, you know, sometimes things are very confusing because each one has their own version. I do respect the fact that sometimes everyone might have their own versions of energy science because nothing is right or wrong to be particular. But navel and solar plexus are two different chakras because solar plexus is a three-dimensional chakra and navel is a fifth-dimensional or a higher-dimensional chakra. Some say it's a four-dimensional chakra as well. It is right located between sacral and your solar plexus. So some say it is the point which Lord Vishnu, when they say in Sanskrit, Shantakaram Bhujaga Shayanam Padmanabham Suresham, which means there is from his navel a lotus was born. So Nabhi, which is also considered, if you look at Indian philosophy, it is considered to be a very strong point. It's because that is the navel chakra. But what is the navel chakra all about? The navel chakra governs the divine masculine qualities of courage, strength and protection of the weak, summing up to empowerment. This is the chakra of empowerment. And it will only be open when you are ready to empower yourself and others. If you are trying to bring others down and if you are going to get stuck in the competition, this chakra will be closed. And Archangel Gabriel, now Archangel Gabriel is also the archangel of communication and the angel of Archangel Gabriel is often called as the maternal or the loving angel and the angel of creation, communication and your creativity. And as they say, your creativity comes from your navel. And Archangel Gabriel along with sacral and the navel chakra governs both the chakras together. Now this chakra is located right between two of our three-dimensional chakras. And even the Japanese talk about this chakra, they call it as Hara. So Hara or Hara, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know how to pronounce it exactly. Yeah, but it's the Japanese center of emotional harmony. And many times when, because I practice Reiki, they say that when you practice the Reiki meditation, many times this chakra is where you are sending the energy. So the key, this chakra is key in digestion and absorption of foods, thus influencing metabolism and weight control. Now, this is a very important aspect and in today's world, obesity is a big concern. I see a lot of people believe that anything which is not skinny or thin is fat, which is not the case. But at the same time, there are people who are obese and they are trying their best to lose weight and they are not able to. Here we are talking about obese, we are not talking about the way media has made things and where I see very young girls going on diets to become skinny and not being in their actual physical health. So we are talking about obesity here. So here, so what again I'm trying to talk about is there's a lot of polarity. So people either are overweight or they are very skinny and the fit health is often underestimated. And when people talk about food and when people talk about exercising, they only and only talk about losing weight and they don't talk about anything else. Now why is this happening? Because people are so stuck in the polarity of thoughts. It's a very third dimensional quality. So I see a lot of women especially, but so many of my friends who are just the very good the way they are, and they still keep saying, oh my god, I've become so fat. That's not fat. You're comparing yourself to media models who are photoshopped. Or worse, they go for fat removal treatments and go on fat diets. We are not talking about that here. But the problem with today's world is people are shaming people who are trying to be normal. So there is a lot of polarity here. You see, there is either you are very thin or either you are very fat. And some people say, if you are not very thin, you are fat. So that is the polarity which is happening because this chakra is closed. Because the food we eat, again, gaining and losing weight is not about the food we eat. It's also about the emotions. Because it has been proven that people who have excess weight on their body are trying to hide behind that weight, which means they are trying to put a protective layer around it. So this is an alarming problem which is occurring currently. And the navel chakra, which is between the solar plexus and sacral, will be the chakra which governs digestion of food, metabolism. And that's the reason when you eat high vibrational foods, your higher chakras will also start automatically opening.
Yes.
We go to the next chakra, which is the causal. Now causal chakra is right behind us. So you know, if you see old scriptures and old Indian mythology, we see a lot of gods and goddesses having that halo behind them. Right? I'm going to share some pictures in a bit to explain that more. So that is what we call as the causal chakra. It is at the back of your head. It is this area. Yeah, center back of our head. 3 to 4 inches behind. It's governed by an archangel called Archangel Christian and the twin flame Archangel Mallory. Now what is a twin flame? The angel in a masculine and feminine form. So not to be confused for husband-wife, because husband-wife is a very third dimensional concept. Here we are talking about two representatives of the same soul. Because in angelic realm, it's an energy. There is no physical body to the angel. So Archangel Christian and twin flame Mallory govern this chakra. And this chakra is white and has feminine qualities of love, compassion and intuition as well as purity. When this chakra is opened to higher consciousness and when our body raises its vibration with the qualities of compassion, love and intuition, this chakra gets activated. So this is all about the higher wisdom, connection to the spirit, and here they also talk about activating the right brain. Now what do you mean by activating the right brain? Do you know about two hemispheres of the brain?
Right is supposed to be logic.
So left is the logical brain.
Left is the right.
The left brain controls your right side and the right brain controls your left side. Now your left side is all about logic, analysis, calculations. Your right is about innovation, creativity, intuition, out of the box thinking. So both brains need to be balanced.
Inside, in harmony.
But currently we are living a reality which they call as the old paradigm, wherein only the left brain is you are looked as an intelligent person if you talk about in left brain manner. What about the right brain? Both need, I'm not saying listen only to right brain, but both need to work together. It's like you need the mother and the father, both of them, to take care of the child. So your left brain is the masculine energy, that's why your right side is the masculine side of your body, your physical body. Your right brain governs your left side, which is supposed to be your feminine side of the body. Both need to be completely in balance with each other, because that's the way all the creations in the worlds were formed. Someone got an idea in the right brain, they took action after using their left brain. What will happen if I only keep getting ideas in my right brain and I'm not taking any action? And if I'm only working with the left brain and only seeing the logic and only seeing what is there in front of me, I will not open to the creative side of me and I will never create something new. All the people, the visionaries, the masters, so they got the idea in the right brain. They used it and they balanced it and hence they listened to the right brain. And in the last few years, we are seeing that a lot of people who have right brain qualities are looked down upon. So if you are an artist, people say, "Arey artist hai, toh kya karega? Paisa kidhar se milega?" We don't, now things are gradually changing, but children aren't encouraged to pursue their artistic careers. Everyone wants their child to become a lawyer, a doctor, or an engineer. That's it. And nothing else. But if the whole world is full of doctors, engineers, and lawyers.
CAs,
yeah. Who will write the books? Who will sketch? Who will draw the art? Who will make beautiful things? So the whole thing is that it has been looked down upon, and with causal chakra, if you're trying to open your right brain, or if you're trying to open your creativity, activating the causal chakra will definitely help. And because it will help us to see the big picture through the power of intuition and creativity. So this is the third one, which is behind our back, white in color, shines when activated. This chakra is also linked to the moon, because the causal chakra has a divine feminine energy. Usually moon talks about the divine feminine energy in the universe, and sun talks about the divine masculine energy. As I said, both energies should be in balance, irrespective of whether you are a man or a woman. We have our both sides, and we need to understand that both should be in balance. So again, you know, both the left and right brain, sun and moon, divine masculine and divine feminine. If we talk about nadis, we talk about the Ida Nadi and the Pingala Nadi, both are masculine, feminine. So in the whole world it's full of this. But again, which is a polarity, because in the fifth dimension, we transcend beyond it. Because we are living in the third dimension, we are still in the polarity of right and left, male and female. Okay, the next chakra, the Sovan Star Chakra. Now this chakra is above the crown. So same for example, if your crown chakra is here, so if you just touch your head right now over here, you will start feeling your crown chakra. Just feel that energy, right? You feel it? So above crown chakra lies the soul star. Almost 6 inches above the crown chakra. Now this chakra is governed by archangels Zadkiel and Amethyst. Do you remember we spoke about these archangels when we discussed violet flame here? Archangel Zadkiel is the keeper of the violet flame, which is the fifth dimensional flame of alchemy. It's an energetic flame which can transmute anything which comes to you. There are two more archangels. Again, Zadkiel and Amethyst are twin flames, and so are Archangel Nariel and Lavender, who are again twin flames. This Magenta Chakra stands for divine knowledge and cosmic wisdom. So people who do channeling, which means people channel information from a source. People say, I connected to that master in my meditation. You know, we have so many people who connect to Sai Baba, or who connect to Lord Ganesha, or who connect to some master, and they channel messages. So this is the energy center which helps you connect to the higher sources to get divine knowledge and cosmic wisdom. Claircognizant people, what's claircognizant? Claircognizance is the getting knowledge. You people get downloads. All of a sudden you get information about your friend, you tell your friend, you know what, that property thing you're working on, it will take a few months but it will happen. And that friend said, what rubbish are you talking, that's not going to happen. Just trust it and it will happen. And 3 months down the line, the friend calls you, you know what happened, that property thing got sorted. You told me, no, I didn't tell you, the divine told me. What rubbish are you talking, how can the divine tell you? Of course, how will I know? I don't know about your property thing. There is some other superpower which told you about it. That is what we call as claircognizance, where people get downloads, information about absolute things they are not even aware of, and there is no logic behind it. If you ask them how, they don't know. So this chakra, which is the higher dimensional or the fourth dimensional chakra, is magenta in color. This again represents the divine feminine of worldly knowledge combined with spirituality, taking towards cosmic wisdom. Now this is an important sentence, because the worldly knowledge and the cosmic wisdom, when blended together, can be useful to us. If there is only cosmic wisdom available, if you are not applying it to your day-to-day life, it's not going to work. We connect through this chakra with the galaxies, thus taking information from a galactic source. So, a lot of information which is available in the universe can be accessed by activated soul star chakra. And together, the stellar and soul star can help achieve spiritual and earthly balance. Now, what is the stellar chakra? We will go to that next. This is the highest chakra. I am not saying exactly the highest chakra, because the universe is infinite and there could be something beyond it. But the knowledge which I have as of now, taken from my teachers, from all the books I've read and learned from everything I know, this is the highest chakra, which is almost 12 inches above your head, and now it has gold color. So when we talk about what they call as the universal consciousness, which can be defined as called as the Christ consciousness or the Krishna consciousness or whatever you call it, these are religious terms made by religious people, but when we talk about spirituality, the consciousness is same. So this consciousness is activated through the stellar gateway chakra, and Archangel Metatron works with this chakra. Now I want to talk a few words about Archangel Metatron. Among the 15 archangels which are known as of now, Archangel Metatron is the teacher of angels. So he is like a spiritual teacher, and he holds something in his hand called as Metatron's cube. I would love to have a talk on angels sometime, because it's my all-time favorite topic. Archangel Metatron holds an energetic cube which contains all the shapes and sizes in the universe. That is supposed to be the cube of energy, and they say that if you just ask him to swipe that cube across your body, just the way we swipe our debit cards and credit cards, if you quickly swipe that energetic cube across your body, it has the power to heal all the chakras and take away all the energetic blockages from you. Archangel Metatron also works a lot with giving you the esoteric knowledge. So you know, all this knowledge is given by Archangel Metatron. So Archangel Metatron energetically will come while you sleep, he will come in your dreams, he will give you ideas, and next time your subconscious mind will give some ideas to your conscious mind. Your conscious mind will take some decisions which will lead you to a right teacher, or you will walk in a store, you will find a book, you will come across a video, and you will connect energetically to the right things. But what is happening? Archangel Metatron is the moment Archangel Metatron understands that you have that, but you should have the willingness. He is not going to do that to everyone and anyone, nor are there chosen ones. The ones who make a choice are the chosen ones. So if someone is making a choice to know more, to use more of spiritual magic, to know more spiritual alchemy, to know how the world works, Archangel Metatron will connect to them and will try. Because when we pray, when we ask angels, dear angels, help me, what will they do? Archangel Metatron will energetically connect to you and give you the commands which you will use it and you will understand it. So this chakra is governed by Metatron. Metatron is all about the golden light. The golden light of Metatron. And this chakra contains all the experiences we have across lifetimes, which we can access once it's activated. That's why people get past life downloads. But if you're not going to work on them, and if you're just going to use it for entertainment, you're going to shut it there. So many people say, I want to see my past life, it must be fun. I said, are you sure you want to see your past life? Because it could be quite a traumatic experience. And once you open, it's like a Pandora's box, right? So once you start opening it, things will start coming up. So people come to me and they say, oh, do you do past life regression? I just want to experience it. I was like, don't do it for the fun of it. It's something very sacred, exactly. And only if there is a problem which you can't solve. So I know people who have physical issues, and probably they are trying to do everything possible. They have birth defects and they are trying to know how to heal them. In that case, yeah, PLR could be a good therapy. But a word of caution to all people who want to explore past lives, do not get into it unless you really want it. At the same time, sometimes, you know, many people get past life downloads as they start working on themselves. So, you know, with modalities, with violet flame or with all of this, a lot of people have seen their past lives. But again, your mind will only show you what you're ready to see. So use all the learnings from that past life. Don't be stuck in the drama, trauma. Oh, I had this past life, and in that past life I had killed someone. Don't stay in that. Learn from it. Know why it has been shown to you. Ask the universe, why have you shown this to me? What do you need? Work on it. Take your lessons. Go ahead. Always use it, because every revealing is a healing. So, because healing is revealing and revealing is healing, whenever you see past life downloads, use it. See a teacher, see a spiritual teacher who will help you to understand what it is. Don't just go to someone who is not experienced and misuse it. So stellar gateway usually holds everything about whatever has happened to you across lifetimes, and it's a gateway to source. Okay? And now if you look at the term stellar and gateway, so you know when I wrote this, I had written this article on higher chakras on a website called Reiki Rays around 3 years ago, and that time the movie was released, Interstellar. So people are asking me, is the stellar gateway related to Interstellar? So stellar actually means stars, and gateway actually means the way to go somewhere, yeah? The gateway of India, we have gateway. So stellar gateway typically means opening that can be closed by a gate towards the stars. The chakra actually is a gateway to stars, which means the higher vibrations. This is said to be the sixth dimensional chakra, so it goes beyond the fifth dimensions and stands for our access to the ultimate source. When does it shut down? However, once the ego starts seeping in. So what is ego? Ego is not just egoistic nature. Ego is when you believe more in yourself than the spirit, and rather I would put it this way, when you believe you and the spirit are different, that is what you call as ego. Because if you believe you are the spirit, and if you believe, then you are, you know that everything is same, because we all eventually are the same, same source, we are from the same source, we just different, have different bodies made of dust and the five elements, and that's why we are three-dimensional beings. But eventually we all are the same because we are the source. The moment you understand that, you understand what you are. But the moment you understand you are not the source and you are the separate one, you go back to your ego thinking. It is said to be the source of highest link to the cosmos, interstellar, and it is timeless. So it's a timeless chakra. It's golden in color, obviously has to be, and that's why the reason the gold is the highest color, and that's why gold is so expensive, and that's why you all want to buy gold, isn't it? Even in the materialistic arena, we all want to buy gold. And we want to show how much gold we have to prove that we are higher. So this is the spiritual gold, which is the highest vibration, and it is said to have all the representations of your spiritual achievements. Okay, now I'm going to talk about two more chakras, the higher heart and higher throat. So higher heart chakra, also sometimes called as the thymus chakra. So medically, thymus gland starts, it is. So till you are a child, thymus is active. After that it becomes a vestigial gland, which means it is non-functional and it reduces. But they say that in the higher frequencies, thymus chakras can get activated and can help you deal with compassion, give you extra boost of energy. So as for energy science, you can develop your thymus back. The experiments are still going on. I haven't yet found how to do that or something. But in a lot of modalities, for example, in access consciousness, they do talk about thymus, and we can activate the thymus and to give extra energy, extra boost of energy. So the higher heart chakra deals with the universal compassion, which means compassion towards each and every being. Although Archangel Samuel works with the heart chakra, the higher heart chakra once opened to the heart. So they say that the heart chakra has, 10 petals or 16 petals. No, sorry, the throat has 16 petals, the heart chakra has 12 petals. They say that, but when more than that, 33 petals of the heart chakra are opened, it moves to the level of a higher dimensional heart chakra. Similarly, a higher throat chakra, which is also, so what is your throat chakra basically? So your throat chakra is all about the way you communicate, the way you communicate to others, but more than that, the way you communicate to yourself.
Sorry.
So when you are communicating to yourself, so you know, it's a journey. I always call this a journey, because the moment we start realizing that negative self-talk is the only thing which actually makes us sick. The only reason we fall ill is because we talk to ourselves very badly. Sometimes, you know, just sit and do an inventory of what you are saying to yourself. Especially when you make a mistake, especially when you get late for work, especially when something wrong happens at office, something wrong happens, probably your child doesn't do the homework and you blame yourself for it, or probably when you don't get the job and you say, oh, I'm not good enough. These things are the reasons why, and it goes on for years and years and years, and then we say old age issues. नहीं, old age issues नहीं हुआ है, क्या हुआ है? बहुत साल अपने खुद को बुरा बोला है. 30 साल हो गए, 40 साल हो गए, 50 साल हो गए, 60 years के बाद maybe the body says enough now, I can't take it. and that's why we nicely call them old age issues. Right? But the problem is the negative self-talk has been going on for so long, which we need to change. So the higher throat chakra typically opens when your internal talk starts getting high vibrational. So these two chakras are the higher aspects of heart and throat chakra and are opened when you are opening to the higher energies or where you are working more on yourself to reach to a level where you are raising your vibrations. Okay? And now I'm going to show you some pictures. So here is our favorite Lord Vishnu.
The thing is Shantakaram Bhujaka Shayanam Padmanabham Sureshnam,
which means the Lord who sleeps on the ocean bed, and the serpent or the Sheshnag is right behind him, and from his navel there stems a beautiful lotus, and that's why the navel chakra. So you know the reason I'm showing this picture is for you to understand that navel chakra is a superpower. And in between, I got one forward on WhatsApp. I don't know how relevant it was, that you can treat any disease by putting oil in your navel. So every disease will have, and navel is a very powerful source of energy, and just know the disease, know the right kind of oil, and that will help. I really don't know how.
Stem cells.
Yeah, I really don't know how true that is, but it was an article which really captured my attention.
It was.
Yeah. And in many ancient modalities, there's a lot of work which people do on the navel.
Yes.
Because navel is a powerful energy center, and there you understand. Now it's just a physical being, but before it was a energetic center. And again, we have him here because we are trying to show the causal chakra right behind his back and the soul star above his head. And the aura you see he is in, that is because he himself is a God knows which dimensional, because he is the God, he is Vishnu, the universal Krishna consciousness or the Vishnu consciousness. So you are seeing his aura, you are seeing these extended rays of
energy
which is behind him, and the causal chakra and the soul star chakra, and that is how. And you know, if you look at Atlantis experiment and what we talk of Satyug, there are a lot of similarities which will trap in it, because in Satyug also people had magical qualities, people could just look at all the elements and you know, those kind of things. So according to all mythologies, Earth was at much higher vibration then, vibrating at 5th, 6th, maybe 7th or 9th dimensions, and now we are here at 3. So, violet flame. Now, why am I talking today again about the violet flame? That is because violet flame is one of those divine flames which is a high dimensional energy. So, when we talk about alchemy, what does an alchemist do? He takes lead and he converts it into gold. He applies some kind of fire. Everything in this world is alchemy. When we make food in our kitchen, the flame on which we cook is also violet in color. We can see it with our eyes though. But a raw vegetable, which is cut, chopped, we put all spices and everything and we make something delicious and everyone eats it. What has happened? It has changed form, right? The fruit or the vegetable which was raw has changed form with the fire. Violet flame is similar in alchemic, alchemy flame in energetic form. So anything which put into violet flame will turn into gold. If you put fear energy, it will turn to gold. If you put worry energy, it will turn into higher vibrational. So you know, the modality which violet flame is about, it teaches you to take anything which doesn't serve you any longer, put it in the flame and convert it into something else. Because we know energy can't be created, nor it can be destroyed, but it can change form. The basic law of physics, which also applies to spirituality and metaphysics, and violet flame can actually clear a lot of things because it will change form. So when we are looking at the higher chakras, how does violet flame help us? So if you are trying to raise your vibrations, to go to a level where you are trying to access your higher chakras, use the violet flame to transmute everything that doesn't serve you. All that is three-dimensional quality can be transmuted with violet flame. And once that is done, your vibrations will rise we'll start looking different. People have transformed when they started using the violet food. And once the vibrations rise, you will be able to tap your fifth vibration, fifth dimensional self. So you know, it's not that once you reach the fifth dimension, you're going to stay there. You'll keep coming back and flow. So there will be days you'll be working at the fourth dimension. There will be days you'll be working at the fifth dimension. There will be days you'll still be at the third dimension. So it's all about your journey. You'll keep to and fro because your thoughts will determine. That's why we say, whenever you are in a negative thought, change it. But more than that, transmute it. So you know, rather than not facing that those thoughts and changing. So changing can the beginning, the first step is changing. The next step is actually acknowledging all that you have, transmuting it to something else, and creating the high vibrational energy via the violet. I often talk about unicorns because unicorns is another mythical topic which people talk about. Having said that, unicorns are higher dimensional beings. They work beyond the 7 to 9 dimensions. And if you see unicorn, so you know, in the third dimension, if you are working at the third dimensional level, unicorns will be a myth. If you are at the fourth dimension, you will believe that okay, there is some fact to unicorn, we can maybe connect to them. And in the fifth dimension, you will believe that unicorns do exist and you will be using their energy. So unicorns can help you. If you connect with unicorns, they can help you open up your higher chakras, because the moment you think about unicorns, the energy of their situation increases. Unicorns have that energy. The energy of the word unicorn or the term unicorn is to transmute, to take any lower energies away and create a higher energy portal to them. Okay, so the higher chakra journey, coming finally to now, we spoke about the higher chakras, we spoke about the dimensions, the Atlantis, violet flame. Now, what do we do? Now you know, every topic that the audience asks, so what is in it for us, you know? And unless we as the speakers identify what is in it for you, you will just go back with the questions in mind. So, what is this higher chakra journey all about? So, they say that if you want to access these higher chakras, stay in high vibrations. If you are in the low vibrations, the chakras will automatically shut down. Okay? So I just hope all whatever I have written helps you at least understand. Because the moment you realize, oh, I have 5 more chakras and I can work on them, at least you will take the first step. So there is a lot more to the 12 chakras than written in this this particular thing. So, you know, Diana Cooper has amazing research on this. I have read, I think, a lot of her books along with a lot of other information, consulted my teachers, all the teachers with whom I learned and researched on this topic, and you know, which is what I'm putting forward, whether it's this talk or whether it is my article which I published. So there's a lot more to that. I also tell most people that everything you are not going to find in books. You have to find some internal answers which will come to you in meditations. So a few days ago, I had the privilege of meeting Mr. Jack Canfield of Chicken Soup for the Soul and doing the training under him. So he spoke this wonderful thing which made me believe in the meditation practice once again. So Mr. Canfield says that the book Chicken Soup for the Soul was ready to be published and he was not finding a suitable title to it. And meditate every day. So you know, I think it's very important for us to meditate every day. Many people ask me, is it your age to meditate? I say, I think any age. I think if you begin with children, I think they will become much more conscious adults. And the more you meditate, your health will get better, your relations will get better, your work will get better, you'll get more money. I mean, I tell people, because people only understand that. You meditate more, you'll get more money. And they do get, because their mind gets calm now, they get ideas, their productivity improves, and they say, you know, we got more money. So I said, wow, bingo, that's awesome. So, when you meditate, so Mr. Canfield said that he was meditating one day and the answer came to him, a higher power told him, chicken soup for the soul. So he says it's unbelievable. If people don't want to believe, they will not believe. But I trusted the superpower. And for me, chicken soup was when I was ill. My grandmother used to give me chicken soup. So chicken soup for the body when you are sick. And for the soul, because there are people who are sick, they are living in fear and worry and anxiety, and they don't know how to handle that. So chicken soup for the soul, the title came to him in meditation. Meditation brings in answers. Take some time out every day, however busy you are, sit and meditate. Either before you go to bed or either when you get up in the morning. Treat it like how you would treat brushing your teeth. or taking a shower or having food. Reduce TV time maybe and use it for meditation. You will see more results. You will see better visions in meditation than on TV. So Dana Cooper has given some beautiful meditations in her book. And as I said, you know, when I researched on this material, a lot of information when I used to meditate, after which I used to write down in my journal whatever knowledge is coming to me, combining it with all this knowledge and consulting my teachers and coming up with this entire discussion with all of you. But you can always read more and get more information on this. To activate the chakras, go one by one. I feel find a teacher who will help you on this journey and to know how to balance your chakras. Once your vibrations start improving, once your vibrations start rising, make sure you drink more water. Yoga can help open your chakras to a higher level again, but as I said, it's a journey. Anyone who says that someone will touch your head and the chakras will open, know that it's a lie. Do not go for these things. Enjoy the journey towards the higher chakras opening more. Stay grounded. Connect to earth more. Wherever you are, don't let things go in your head. Let everything just flow to you. Always keep the higher energies, as I always do. I give all my worries to the higher energies, be it angels or be it maybe ascended masters. I always, so it's a prayer. Prayer is a humble act. It's an act of saying that whoever, whatever I am, I know there's a power higher than me who's taking care of all my worries. And although we have knowledge and we know everything, but there's a superpower which is working, invisible force which is working with us. When we pray, we surrender. So we tell them that show us the right path. Maybe a right teacher will walk in your life. They will help you with finding yourself, with giving you answers. Read a lot. Meditate a lot. Stay in high vibrations. And again, you know, for further reading, if anyone wants to read more on this, I think most of the things of my article I've covered in this. So Reiki Rays has published my article. I'm a writer with this particular website. And if you just go for Reiki Rays and you add my name and you put on like, you put in Google Reiki Rays, Ashwini Chube, Higher Chakras, will find the article. It's the original article written by me. So that is, if you want to read more, you could go for that. Diana Cooper, as I say, is one of my teachers because I have done a few online courses with her. I have read her books and I think she's fantastic. I hope someday I'm able to meet her and learn with her in person. She has some fantastic work on Atlantis, on ascension, on unicorns, on higher chakras. So feel free to read all of that. And that brings us to the end of this beautiful talk. I wish it never got over and I wish there was so much more to discuss. But looking at our time and I think we still had a great discussion today. And do feel free to let me know for any questions. And these are my details. So unicorninsight.com is my website. Over there everything about, you know, what courses I do and everything is written. And this is my Facebook page. Because I share a lot of videos there, so do like if you really like my talks and if you want to learn more, I'm active here. And you could always drop me an email on unicorninsight@gmail.com. And finally, would conclude by saying Namaste. The divine in me honors the divine in you.
Divine.
Namaste. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good.